A man has joy by the answer of his mouth. And a word spoken in due season, how good is it? The way of life is above to the wise, that he may depart from hell beneath. That's Proverbs 15:23-24. Hell awaits a lot of people. The Bible says it's an origin daily to make ruin for those who don't serve the Lord. A lady called me out of North Carolina. Said, why do you preach so much on hell? I said, well, it's a place that people are going. If you're not right, you're going. Today, church, I cut no slack for no man, no woman. I know there's a lot of Bible, a lot of stuff in the Bible to preach. But the future book, which is Revelation, gets a coming. Bad things are coming to good people. Why? Because they won't repent. They won't serve the Lord. The hypocrites around. But I'm here to tell you today, if we don't go by the book, hard times to come for a lot of good people.
That's right, amen.
Today, church, put your faults and your failures out yonder. Repent of your sins and just have church.
Amen.
Okay? Stand with me if you will. Just go to the Lord in prayer and ask God to help you in every day walk of life, whatever your need might be, you know. Ask God to help you with it. I can pray for you, but I can't help your needs. It takes sometimes me to get myself where I ought to be in order to receive anything from the Lord. So let us pray. Father, we come today and thank you, loving God, for a day of time you made for us. Asking God that you touch your heart, so my God, to the people of the church today. Pray for the presence of God to come. Pray for you to come to the people. For whatever it was they want, need, we ask you today, God, to grant unto them, Father, we pray. Move greatly upon the house of God, the people. Amen. That God has been helping you, alone out there, lost and undone. Oh, God, here today, we ask you to help you.
Never Amen. Ain't it good to be here?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Let me do my business for the King today.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Can't bring any other reason we couldn't just stay home on a rainy day. Amen. Hallelujah. Water's rising. Hallelujah. Glory to God. But this, no matter how high the water gets, there's always a call in the wind. Hallelujah. For somebody to come home. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. So if anybody be lost in the house today and they need salvation, or if anybody needs to just pray, needs to be standing in prayer line for themselves or for a friend or a loved one, now's the time to do it. Amen. Hallelujah. We're just in here to work and do something for the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And offer what we have and share what we have. Amen. Hallelujah. The greatest thing I can offer you, and the thing, best thing I'm going to leave behind, hallelujah, is a thought about Jesus Christ. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Because if you just sow a seed and get in somebody's heart, and it would just all of a sudden take root, hallelujah, sure, you start growing, hallelujah, it'd be worth it all. Can you say amen?
Amen.
It'd be worth it all. Amen. Hallelujah. Three men on a mountain upon Calvary. Was a man in the middle of Jesus. He died for you and me. It's three men on a mountain upon Calvary. Was a man in the middle of Jesus. He died for you.
Right.
fear not to serve thee, for this day, Lord. You'll be with me in paradise on heaven's golden shore. All creeping on the mountain up on Calvary. Lord, have mercy. Oh, the man in the middle was Jesus. He died for you and me. Yes, the man in the middle was Jesus. He died for you and me. If it had not been for a man named Jesus, where would we be at today, church?
Amen.
We'd be lost in a world of sin. And you say amen. But because, hallelujah, of him, hallelujah, we're among sin, but we're not all sin. Can you say amen? Because we've been cleansed by the blood. Can you say amen today, church? Glory to God, hallelujah. I said, you really don't realize what a powerful blood that is. Hallelujah, glory to God. No other blood, hallelujah, glory to God, can take away, can cleanse of sins, but the blood of Jesus. Can you say amen? Glory to God, hallelujah. He came, glory to God, and laid a plan of salvation. Glory to God, hallelujah. And Lord have mercy, nobody has to stand back, glory to God, and say, it's not for me. But he said, oh, Slester, he said, whosoever will. Can you say amen? Glory to God. And whoever wants to bow down, hallelujah, lift up their hands and cry out to Hosanna Bahia and cry out, Abba, Father. It don't matter who you are, where you come from, or where you've been, it's where you're at when you talk to God. Can you say amen? When you talk to God, hallelujah, because all of a sudden, honey, the old man died. Can you say amen? Honey, the old man, hallelujah, just died. Well, no room for him no more, because a new creature took over in your house. You become a brand new person, church. Glory to God, hallelujah. And I love what God's done for me. Glory to God, hallelujah. I said, ain't nothing but the blood. Such things as these. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You can run to your mommy. And hallelujah. You can run to your daddy. You can run to your neighbor. And I say, you can run to the hospital. I found a time there was not time, honey, to go to the hospital. Honey, you better be a hold of Jesus. Can you say amen? You better hold on to Jesus. Glory to God. Honey, because when it's all said and done, it's going to be you and oh man, I'm a longing for that day.
Bless her, Lord.
I'm a longing for that day when I can just hear him say, enter in.
Amen.
Being faithful over a few days, I had to do everything.
Uh-huh, we did.
Be
a faithful over a few things.
Yeah. Because this old house that you're looking at, it's not much, but what's inside of me,
yeah,
is what's good.
Amen.
Got the power to lift me up.
Yes, Lord.
To when I get my... be changed in the moment, twinkling of an eye. Be lifted up out of this world. Can you say amen?
Amen.
So what do you think about Jesus? Come on, church.
Amen.
What do you think about Jesus?
Amen.
Honey, I tell you what. If he'd stand before you right here today, and he'd say, are you ready? Would you say, yes, Lord?
Come on, Sandy.
Or would you say, wait a little longer.
Come on, Sandy. Obey the Lord.
You, son of mine.
Yeah, come on.
Or just say, wait a little longer. Oh, Lord. Oh, son of mine. Oh, son of mine. He told about my son of mine. Would you say, Father, wait just a little longer. Come on, church. Glory to God. Only it's about getting people, getting souls saved. Glory to God. We're saved and we want them saved, Bobby. Glory to God. Hallelujah. If the Lord would appear, just suppose he'd walk right in here right now, honey. Glory to God. And you can see the physical being of him. And he'd say, are you ready? Would you say, ain't gonna be no hiding place. Can you say amen? Lord God, you gotta get yourself together now. Lord God, because when it's over, honey, it's over. Hallelujah. It ain't over till it's over. But when it's over, it's over. Can you say amen? Fulfilled every day. You hear me? Yes. Honey, we're nearer home today than what we were yesterday, church. Can you hear me now? Hallelujah. The coming of the Lord is closer today than it was yesterday. Can you say amen? Honey, he didn't die in vain. He died for a bride. Can you say amen? Hallelujah. He gave his life for the church. Hallelujah. And if you've been born again and he grafted in, honey, you're the bride. Can you say amen? When you said bride, hallelujah, I beg you.
Lord.
He says, I'll beg him.
Sunday.
I won't come back and get you. But honey, I can beg you from up here all I want to.
Lord. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
You hear me? So I beg you, I plead to you. Get Jesus in your life.
Oh,
somebody's got a license tag on the front of the vehicle that says, don't be caught dead without Jesus.
That's right.
You hear me? We don't need to be caught dead without the Lord in our life. Hallelujah, because where would you be? Let me sing it. My mic, I remember this old song. I don't know. I don't know. I'll sing what I know of it. Can you just raise your hands and love the Lord? Thank you.
Lord. God, without you, I have nothing.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Bless your Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
How many's got that mindset? More than anything in this world, you've got to make it to heaven. No matter what you're going through, you've got to press on and make it on. No, it doesn't matter where your husband's going. Don't matter if your mom and dad's saved. You've got to keep pressing on, because eventually they're going to realize you're living the life that you're supposed to be living, and they're going to come in anyway. Amen. Glory, hallelujah. But I look forward to the day that Jesus comes back and he takes us on to the sister's day. I want to lay my crown at his feet. More than anything, I have got to make it. Glory, hallelujah. That's why all the troubles and trials that we go through, that's our reward, is that we get to see Jesus one day, Brother Otis, and we're going to be able to lay our crowns at his feet. If we've made anything on this life to make a crown, I want to be able to lay it at his feet.
Amen.
I do. I want to lay it at his feet. Glory, hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
Soon this life will end, and I'll hear the sweet sound. There's something I've got to do.
your glory. Hallelujah.
More than
anything,
and what I want to do is lay my crown at His feet.
Glory, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Well, I'm gonna walk right out this valley, leave my head to praise the Lord.
Thank you. Church, I get faulted a lot because I preach much on hell. I promise you one thing today, it's there and people are still going. Amen. I warned the people, I tell them, Johnny, just like it ought to be told. If you don't live it, that's where you're going. Say amen to God. If you live according to the word of God, we're going home to be with the Lord. Now, that's where I want to go home to be with Jesus. Amen. Striving, standing bright to get into the kingdom of God. Amen. Being perfect? No, I'm not. But I tell you, I believe today I've been forgiven. Amen. To God and to me. That's what it's all about, church, is knowing that my name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Amen. Amen. No matter how I act or what I do, Bobby, amen, to God, I want my name to be written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Amen. I know I don't sing, I know I don't preach good, but I tell you one thing about it, church. You can't fault my life, amen. You keep an eye on me, amen. And you see me doing something wrong, then you can tell me, amen, to God, and let me make it right with God, because the day is going to come, church, I will stand before Him, and I'll give account for all that I've done up on this land and for the things I have not done. Amen. The God today, the people want the name of being a child of God, but they don't want to do nothing. Amen. For the Lord. I'm telling you today, congregation, we need to work and do for Jesus, because He's done so much for us and our Christians. Amen. And we do so little for Him today. And the people wonder, what is wrong with my system? What's wrong with my body? Amen. The God, I tell you what the problem is, church. Amen. The God is sin. I'm nothing but sin, church. Amen. The God. Today we need to live according to the word of God. And therefore, when my body gets in trouble, amen. The God, I can call upon God. And He sends down the hell. Amen. The healing that I need today, church. Amen. The God, I'm telling you, Bobby. Amen. The God, a man just strolling around through the mountains all night. I'm running after a stupid coon dog. I cannot be too much wrong. Amen. The God, if Bobby and I was in the mountains last night. Amen. And up he was doing his thing. Amen. The God, and I was walking down the road. Amen. There was a big mud hole, and I didn't see the mud hole. I just walked right out in it. Amen. And while I was in the mud hole, I began to dance. Amen. I got in the mud hole. Listen to me today, church girl. Amen. The God, no, I'm not perfect. I know Bobby likes to just tickle at me sometimes, but Lord, you know what tonight, church? It don't really matter, Bobby. Amen. We have a good time anyway, don't we? My God, listen to me today, church world. That's what it's all about. It's rejoicing in life, amen. They're happiness in serving God. Amen. The God, listen to me today, church. Without Jesus, the Bible said, I am a filthy rag. I may be good for nothing, but with Him, I am somebody. Now, what if you believe it or not? It don't matter to me. I know what I am. You know what you are. Boy. You know where you ought to be with God. If you're not where you ought to be, there's a place where you need to get to be. Amen. Where you ought to be. But listen to me today, church world. The God that I serve is the God that healeth you. Amen. He's the one today. I can keep you out of far. Amen. The God. You know what today, Sandy Bryan? The people don't want out of the floor. They're satisfied with what they had and what they're doing. But I'm going to tell you one thing today. Honey, going to come a time, glory to God, you're going to wish you'd have done better.
Amen.
Not only you, me too. I don't get by with nothing. Hey, man, I'm not that crazy, but I say when it comes to this, I'm not crazy. But I keep my nose stuck in the book a lot. Amen. And I read and I study the Word of God. And I do know right from wrong. And I know if I'm wrong, where am I going to send it, Brian? Hell will awake me. But I don't want to be there before my son come by and say, Daddy, what did you tell me about this awful flame? Listen to me today, church world. I put it to Him just like I do y'all. There are heaven and there are hell. If you don't live right, son, you're going to die. Oh, but Daddy, I help all the people I can. I help everybody trying to preach it. They're trying to quit that. I said, you can quit if you want to. Amen. I said, you don't want to. That's why you don't quit. Listen to me today, church. Well, why you're in sin? Now, I've got friends here. My buddy Jamie back there. I know his daughter, Stephanie, and Lana over there. I would hate to think today I would die lost and go to a devil's hell and hear them come and say, oh, what did you tell us about this awful place? Amen. My God, the day, church, I'm telling you, Jesus is a coming. Oh, we got to go somewhere. I'm to spend the eternity. All the people don't want to hear it. They want the blessings of God. They want to shout the victory. Glory to God, when we get right down under the Word of God, they don't want to hear the Word of God. Anything but the truth. I pat them on the back. I tickle their ears. But I'm telling you today, Jesus is coming, church. You better live it. According to the Word of God. If you don't live it, according to the Word of God, you're going to a terrible, terrible place.
Amen.
Gosh. I would hate to thank my son. I've all done over 2 daughters as a servant of God, but my son's not. And I pray that before I leave this world, I can see him come back.
Amen.
And give his life to God.
Yes.
Amen. Yeah.
That's every mommy and every daddy's wish.
Amen.
I can see my kids come.
Amen.
And give their life to God. There ain't nothing after her church. What's going to hell for?
That's right.
Not one thing, Jeffy. I've been out there, I know what it's like. Uh-huh. I was a troubled Charlie man. All the days of my life, I'm looking for something. Hey, man, but God, I'm looking for peace and happiness. I tried to get it out of a bottle of garlic, but I couldn't get it. Every time I empty one, there was more trouble and more trouble. I kept myself in trouble a lot of times because of it, amen, but God. But listen to me today when I fell on the altar, amen. When I got up, I felt what I was looking for. It was peace and happiness in my soul. Because the Bible said the joy of the Lord is my strength, amen, but God. I'm giving you. You got the joy, I got the peace, the happiness, and got the Holy Ghost to boot. I traded sin for the salvation of God. And I come out of hell, church, glory to God today. One day, Johnny Ray, I'm going home to be with the Lord. Glory to God today. That makes me to know I am something. I am somebody. What do you believe it or not?
Amen.
We are. We sell ourselves out a lot of times, thinking we're nothing.
That's right, it's the truth.
If you're a child of God, I got news for you.
You are
something. Glory to God. Wouldn't it be helpful, Johnny Ray, we get to heaven, get to looking back if we could and say, Lord, look at the power I had down there. Hey, man, the God that never put it to you. Greater than I can do, greater than you can do, than what he done, amen. Why not be the God of God, church? Why not be the Lord of my God? Because he has peace, happiness, and joy. How do you pull a glory deal to see love today, church? I thought he got more than enough for you. Making child gum screams, squall and holler. Hey, man, Johnny Ray, that thing's Honey, amen of God, they're blessings and they're curses.
Amen.
In the Word of God.
Amen.
Why do I have to preach the curses all the time? That's God. He'll tell you why.
Uh-huh.
Amen. I don't have to.
Lord.
I do what He says.
Exactly.
I don't do what my wife says. I don't do what y'all say.
That's right, you can't, brother.
I do what the Lord says.
Amen.
If I can get up at 4 o'clock and read my Bible at 8 in the morning, amen, or 9, while Shannon is sleeping, God said, don't you preach this, you preach that.
That's right.
My God. Drop a heart, ain't it? Yeah, but He said, you preach it. I said, okay, Lord, I'll give it a shot.
Stirring up the
word. But anyway, today, let me share this with you. The Bible said, behold, I will bring in health and cure. And I will cure them, and I will reveal unto them the abundance of peace and truth. Today, church, I'm a firm believer that Jesus Christ is the healer.
Yes, He is.
What if you believe it or not, amen, the choice is yours today. I know every man, every woman in the house today, amen, has got a problem in their system. But it's not His fault, amen, but God, I believe today, darn Christian, the problem is me, amen, it's not Him, because He said, I am the healer, and I believe, Bobby, that He is, amen. Glory to God, I've got aches and pain, where I rode that old four-wheeler last night through the mud, a swarping and a going on, and a waiting the mud holes. Listen to me today, I've got aches and pains all over my body today, but glory to God, today, I can stay at home last night, and I get up this morning, probably wouldn't have an ache or a pain. But Lord, listen to me today. I want to get out there and enjoy life as long as I can. I don't care about the aches, I don't care about the pain. I just let it go. God will take care of it. He'll get over it. Amen. One day, if not, I'll still go to heaven. But one thing about it, when I go through the pearly gate, I'll be no pain. I'll be no sickness. Amen. But God, only health. Amen. But God, let the people today. They don't look at it that way. Honey, amen to God. The only thing they're worried about is self-gain. A big hoorah, hooray, and a good time, amen, which is great. I like to shout myself, amen to God. But I'm telling you today, church world, it takes the word of God, what moves me. I can't help it, church. One preacher said, oh, how can you shout to the word of God? Don't ask me, I don't know. But one thing I do know, that the Word will set me free today.
Yes,
amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
I said, I'll bring health. And I said, Lord, I need it. Today's a good day to pour that on me.
Praise the Lord.
Matthew 10 puts it this way. And when He had called unto Him His 12 disciples, He gave them power against unclean spirits. Yes. Is that not amazing? To cast them out and to heal all manner of sickness and all manner of diseases.
Amen.
Greater than I can do than what He done.
Yes,
what the Bible says, not what I say.
Exactly
what you know tonight, church, I'm not getting the problem done, honey. Amen. It seems like the more I pray for the sick, the worse they get. And some of them even die. Amen to God. But I don't have the answer today. But one thing I do know and believe, dog Christian, that God is still a healing. Amen to God. I tell you today, and now in the name of the 12 disciples, but all them people, and we went down, amen, to verse 5, the 12 Jesus sent forth and commanded them, saying, I go not into the ways of the Gentiles, into the any city of the Samaritan enter ye not, but go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. And as ye go preaching, saying, the kingdom of heaven is at hand, heal the sick, clean the leper, raise the dead, cast out devils. Amen. Freely you have received, freely gift today. My God, today, church, well, what is my problem today? Amen. The God, I don't see the sick healed. Lord, this is me today, Johnny Ray. I find myself. See people heal and find my bones. Amen. The God of all the land of the Lord. Honey, that Jesus is still the healer. And he sent the 12 out. Amen. He told him to go to save the Lord, heal the sick, cast out the demons and the devil. Listen to me today. A lot of church people today, they need healed. They need the blessing of God. Amen. The God, but we don't have it, church. Don't ask me why today. Everybody in the building is healed. We ought to be a perfect. Amen. Hell. Why? Because we believe that Jesus is the healer. My God, from the beginning, the Bible from through, he healed people. Listen today, church world. Amen. We run to the doctor. Amen. Try to get help from the doctor. Amen. The God and the doctor, they give us pills. Sometimes they help and sometimes they don't. Amen. But one thing about it today, glory to God today, I believe that Jesus is the healer. I don't care what you believe. It matters not to me. You got the right, amen, to believe what you want to. But if we don't, honey, then I believe today there's something wrong in the people's life. I know Connie and Steve has been sick ever since, with a sugar diabetes ever since. I've been a pastor in this church, and they're still not healed. I don't have them. Ain't there, amen?
Amen.
I don't know what the problem is. They're not being healed. Amen. Told Shannon the other day, I said, I need to go to the hospital in Winfield. What's the matter? Oh, I got two knots. Come up on the side of my face right there. Amen. There, we put it off, she put it off, I put it off, amen. So one morning I got up, and it dawned on me. I go to the doctor, they ain't gonna cut them things out. Amen to God, and I'll be a big doctor bill. Cost me to go to Bluefield and gas. Then you gotta go out for dinner while you're up there. Well, I was looking at quite a bit of money to be put out. I said to myself, Holmes, I know what you can do. Holy to God, take care of it yourself. I said, okay, Holmes, that's what I'll do. So I went up for them old truck, and I got one of them razor blade knives, amen, in my old truck, and I brought it down to the house door, amen, and I got through to that mirror, amen, to God, and I went, amen, to God, and when I split that, I flipped them things out, amen, to God, and you look today, ain't no not her, baby, only that God today, I will give you the time, the people will take you themselves, amen, to God, but I promise you today, church, it don't matter how I do it, it don't matter how you do it, I bring Jesus still to you.
Amen.
Amen. Take care of yourself.
Amen.
Amen. Look at
Gracie.
Bobby and I split them things. And there's a heart of rocks. I promise you one thing. Hey, man, I could have went to the doctor to get such here. I'm sure he could have. But I've been there a lot of money to get it done. Look, I just took care of it before then. Woo, glory to God. I told you I might be all right. I promise you one thing today, church. Amen, the God, that God that we serve today. Amen, the God is the one that healeth. Amen. Matthew 12 and 22. And said, I was brought unto him one possessed with a devil, bind and bond. And he healed him. My God, the name, church. If God can do that greater than I can do what he done, what is the problem? Amen, the God not yet done. I point a finger at myself. Amen, the God, I don't look at other people. What the problem is with their life. Amen, I look at my own self alone today. Amen, the God that we today, honey, got what it takes, amen, to get your God done, but not put it to you. And not going out there and getting in your truck. Amen, if you don't put it in gear, you give it some gas, it ain't going nowhere. That's the way the gift of God is. If you don't put them to use, amen, it profits you nothing. Amen, the God, while the time is right, it's time to put it together. Amen, and believe. I'll be like Jesus was. Amen, when he went about healing all the people, darling. He didn't pray for an hour and a half for the people. All he said is, be thou made whole. And they were made whole. Holy to God, he even spoke the word, and the dead come alive. My God, today, church, you and I can do the same thing. If only today, church, we
live according to the book, I believe we can get the job done.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I believe that.
God.
Y'all believe what you got to believe. Amen. But it's going to take Jesus. Even though we get into the portal of heaven, we still going to have to depend upon Him for health and healing.
Amen.
And what if you believe it or not, go to Revelation 22 and 2. See what the Bible says about the situation. Amen to God. You tell me. Amen to God. I believe, Johnny Ray, that we can lay a hand on a sick, and I believe they can be healed. Amen. A lot of people don't look at it that way. They run to the doctor, they don't give God time to do nothing. Amen. God, heal me right now if you don't want to head me to the hospital. Amen. That's what I could have done the other day. Amen to God, but no, I didn't do that. Amen. I done the round and done it myself. And it turned out all right. Thank God. Amen. I didn't cut my eyeballs out. Amen. But anyway, today, church world, not real bright. Amen. But the Bible said in Revelation 22 and 2, in the midst of the streets of it, and on either side of the river was there a tree of life, which bears 12 manners of fruit, and yields her fruit every month.
Yep.
And the leaves of the trees were for the healing of the nation. Amen. This is up on heaven. Amen. This is in the New Jerusalem. The leaves is for the healing. Amen. For the people of the nation. Amen. The God, darling, what the people know it or not, and what the doctors believe it or not, you can run a lot of history on that verse right there, Kathy. And every leaf on his trees on that mountain was put here for a healing of some kind. Amen. The God, I'm telling you today, church, I believe that with all my heart, soul, and my mind. Amen. The God, when I was a kid at home, we was poorer than poor. Amen. We was the worst of the poor. Amen. The God, and every time a kid got sick, amen to God, daddy and mommy, one of them would head to the mountain, and when they come back from the mountain, they had what it took, amen, to cure us, amen to God. They might have to cook it a little while, might have to boil it a little while, but the job got done, amen to God. Listen to me today, there was a time in my life, amen, I know it's not going to be a proper thing to say or to do, but amen, all the time, I glory to God when I was a young boy, my feet was ate off. It was like cancer. Both feet was eat plumb up. I could pull my toenails out. Amen to God, it was such a bad thing. And there's a little old humpback lady about the size of Kathy there. Amen. And she walked like this. Amen. I just done the best way I could to get around. And she said, "Oh, what's the matter with you?" I said, "My feet is ate off." She said, "I'll tell you what, cure that if you'll do it." I said, "I'll do anything." And she said, "You see that big black oak right up there?" I said, "Oh yeah, I can see that." And she said, "You go up there and you get that inner bark, get you a bunch of that bark, bring it down to the house, and boil it till it gets good and brown, and soak your feet in, and your feet will be healed." And so help me, Kathy, I numb that, and it wasn't 3 or 4 days, my feet were sound as a dollar. Glory to God. I promise you today, everything out there for all the roots and the berries, which some of them is good to eat, but a lot of them today, if the people today, amen, would pay attention, amen, because God has put stuff there for you and I today.
Amen.
I know it sounds kind of crazy to some of you high society people. Amen. But you know what, Kathy? I've been a person to try anything. Did it help me? And I think it will. I'll try it. Amen. But you know today, church, a lot of people that would have done that. No, you could have hardened them. Amen. To do something like that. I promise you one thing. It worked.
Oh, yeah.
My feet are still sound as a
daughter. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen.
How great God is. Revelation 15
Never like to preach a message without talking about revelation. Vision of heaven.
Oh, yes.
It said, and I saw another sign in the heaven, great and marvelous, seven angels having the seven last plagues, for in them is filled up the wrath of God. Talking about chapter 16 in Revelation. That one verse describes Revelation 16. And it said, I heard a great voice out of the temple saying to these seven angels, go your way and pour out your vial of the wrath of God upon the earth. It's going to be bad, church. That's what I said. I don't want to leave this world without seeing my son saved. I don't want to leave it without seeing Alana. Step up here. I want to see them saved before I die and leave this seeing this world.
Amen.
But anyway, today, when they first went out and poured out his vial upon the earth, there was noise of grievous sores upon the men which had the mark of the beast, and upon them which worshipped the image. Wouldn't it be awful tonight, church? Like your blood from the top of your head to the soles of your feet with little sores. Amen, but it's to come to those that have to go through a revelation time. Amen, to see the sea become like blood. 3 said, and the second angel poured out his vial upon the sea. And it became as blood of a dead man. And every living soul died in the sea. Won't it be amazing, church, to go through a revelation time? One thing about it, darling Christian, I might go through it. I don't say I won't. So if I do, I'll know what tomorrow holds. Amen. But God, why? Because I studied the book. Amen. I promise you, for the last 12 years, about every day of my life, amen, the God sent me bright. I'm in Revelation, of reading and studying. All the books I've got, I've got truckloads of books about Revelation. I study and I read. I'm trying to learn something, amen. But one thing I did learn, amen, it's there, amen. And if I don't live according to the book, I will go through it, possibility, amen, the God. You said, oh, you're already old, you might die tomorrow, you might die today, but if I don't, amen, Jesus might come tomorrow, then Revelation will start, and through the 7 years there, amen, the God said that I might go through some of this. Listen to me today, church world, we don't have to go through it, amen, the God live according to the Bible, by the 4th chapter rapture takes place, you can get out of here, you can escape all of this. I know you don't like to hear this.
Sounds good, brother.
But being if you hear, you might as well listen. And the third angel poured out his vial upon the river and the fountains of water, and they became blood. Boy, won't that be plumb amazing? I hear the angel of the water saying, thou art righteous, O Lord, which thou was and shall be, because thou hast judged us. For they had shed thee blood of saints and prophets, and thou hast given them blood to drink, for they are worth. And I heard another of the angels saying, even so, Lord God Almighty, true and righteous are thy judgment. And I believe tonight, amen, his judgment is righteous. I believe what the Bible said, it's a coming church. Amen, the God, you better be ready. You better be part if he was to come today or tomorrow. Honey, you need to have your soul right with God. Honey, because if you don't, amen, your days of trouble have just begun. I try to tell everybody in goods and magic marks everywhere I go. I tell the people I spent 30 to 45 minutes up there in the parking lot the other day trying to tell a man about the coming of the Lord. And he said, oh, I'm coming to your church Sunday. I'll bring my wife and I'm going to bring my daddy. But you know what, tonight, church, he never made it. Amen, the God, for some reason. Listen to me today. Honey, amen, the lost out there, they want something, amen, more than what they got, amen. And the people, amen, don't want to take a little bit of time and tell them about judgment day is coming. I know God is a blessing. My God, I know that. I know he is the healer. But I do know judgment day is coming. And it's going to be bad for a lot of people.
Amen.
And the fourth thing, he poured out his vial upon the sun. And power was given unto him to scorch men with fire. The sun's going to be hot. You're going to be scorched before you get in the fire. Amen. And men were scorched with great heat and blasted fiends the name of God, which had power over these plagues. And they repented not to give him glory. You know, that's the way our family. Some of our children could turn out to be this way. Some of them might have to go through this. The pain might be so hard. They're all Christian, that they will still curse God because of the pain. And I read over there where they said the hailstones will fall. A 100-pound apiece will front from the people, and they still curse God because of the pain. Why not live with Jesus? Amen. Don't have to worry about this stuff. All we got to do is live for Him. And we don't have to go through this. But if we don't live for Him, there's a very possibility that you can go through it. Amen.
Oh, yes.
Look what Ken said. In the 15th of 40, his battle upon the great sea of the beast, and his kingdom was full of darkness. And they groaned their tongue for pain and blasphemed the God of heaven because of the pain in the soul and repented not of their deeds. You know, in that church, that's why I constantly tell people, you live a sign on the back of my own truck. Read it when you go out. When the Revelation Nation. Darrell, we just about as close to the Revelation as we've ever been. I believe, y'all believe what you got to. But I believe today, you can talk tomorrow.
Amen.
I believe that. No, believe what you want to. Live just exactly how you want to. If you don't want to do no better than what you're doing, nothing I can do about it. But don't criticize me for what I do. Johnny Yates told me about it on Friday night. He said, if you want to hear about hell, fire, and brimstone, go to Olson's church. But they won't come, or they don't want to hear it. Amen. Tell you something, Jamie. What people believe it or not, buddy, it's going to be tough. That's on a lot of people. A lot of throwing no hits, no slurs, but I'd hate to think that I didn't hit.
That's right.
And your blood will be required at my hands. That would be a good thing, church.
Amen.
12:7-16, you poured out his battle upon the great river Euphrates tree, and the water thereof was dried up, that the way of the kings of the east might be prepared. And I saw three unclean spirits like crows come out of the mouth of the dragon, and out of the mouth of the beast, and out of the mouth of the false prophet.
Yeah, come on.
Bad ugly thing, for they are the spirits of devils. Woo, glory to God for these. Working miracles which goes forth unto the kings of the earth and to the whole world to gather them to the battle of the great day of God Almighty. Amen. Behold, I come as a thief. Blessed is he that watches and keeps his garment, that he walks naked and sees no shame. Listen today, church. Amen. There's going to be some bad things come out, amen, upon the land to terrorize and to torment the people. Honey, through a revelation time, glory to God, get your soul right and get your heart right with God. Amen. Don't have to worry about your stuff. I don't fret body. Don't worry about it. Amen. The God, only thing I want to do is live my life for Jesus. I can't live to please y'all. I can't preach to please you. But one thing I can do, I can please him, amen, that called me. I can please him that forgave me. I can please him that heals me. And that's all that matters to me, honey. As long as I'm a pleasing Jesus, that's all that matters to me. Don't be God to me. Honey, we need to please him. If I don't please the wife, if I don't please nobody, I've got to please God.
Amen.
Because he's the man who does the final say so.
Yes.
Oh, my God.
Yes, he is.
Y'all can say all you want to, talk about me all you want to, judge me all you want to. What matter to me? He's got the final say so, darling. That's where I'll spend eternity. If I stand before him, which I will, he says, enter in those, I've got it made. If he says, depart, I'm going to get it made. Amen. He gathered them together into the place called Hebrew. Amen, my God. And the seventh angel poured out his vial upon the air, and there came a great voice out of the temple of heaven from the throne, said, it is done. And there were voices and thunders and lightning, and there were great earthquakes, such as was not since men were upon the earth, so mighty an earthquake and so great. Hey man, I watched the TV news sometimes, and all them other countries over yonder, earthquakes is real bad. I'm killing the people by the thousands, amen, the God. But they've never seen nothing like this, amen. This is going to be something to behold that your mind can comprehend, church. Amen, the God. I tell you what, I want to be up there maybe looking down. I don't want to be here looking up, because one thing about it today, church, the great earthquake, I read where the earthquake coming. They're covering up the people, I see, where the earth opens up and swallows up people and things. Listen to me today, God has done everything can be done to try to get the people's attention, girl, to serve him, but they're still not listening.
That's right.
They don't put no attention.
Come on, praise the Lord.
It's self-gain. What I can get out of the world.
Yeah.
God's got what you need.
Amen.
Amen.
You got just exactly what you need.
Amen.
Just put it in the hands of God. You take care of it, God. I can't. You take care of it. And the great city was divided into three parts. Can you imagine that?
Yep.
How he can do it? By the word. It comes out of his mouth. And the city of the nation fell in great Babylon, come into remembrance for God to give unto her the cup of the wine of the fires of his wrath. And the islands fled away, and the mountains were not found. What a heavenly time that's going to be. We're going to flatten out the land. Mountains will disappear. People will disappear. Glory to God. Won't it be wonderful? No, it will not, church. You don't need to go there. Amen. The God has said this, if thou fill upon men a great hell out of heaven, and every stone but the weight of a talent, and men blesses me God because of the plague of the hell, for the plague thereof was exceedingly great.
Amen.
See, church, love the Lord. Give God what's due to him. The joy of the Lord belongs to all of us. Christian people, if you don't have the joy, you need to get back on the altar. Lost without God, this is where you need to be. Therefore, you can get what you want from him. Amen. I'm going to tell you, God has got just exactly what you need. He knows how to fix your problem. Amen. He knows just exactly how to do that.
You see that?
I make a mess of stuff. When I turn it over to him, Bobby, just as smooth as butter. Just right. I don't have to worry about it. Amen.
So
that's about poor Johnny Ray. That's why I live a happy life. I know the God that I serve and thank you of all my needs, thank you of all my problems. So why should I worry? I don't worry. Don't worry about the body, don't worry about the health. Amen. People tell me about it. Lord, y'all get out on them four wheelers when I do die of pneumonia. So be it. I've got a place to go. And I got faith in my God. Amen. So tonight, church, where's your faith? How's your life? You live a happy life? Or do you not? And if you don't, you need to get on an altar somewhere. Pray.
Praise God. Talk to God. Amen. He can fix it for you. Then I said, they're going at the end of the book.
Blessing
Lord. Cursing God. Sure will. Today, church, where are you going to spend eternity? If Jesus was to come today, or tomorrow, would you be right, or would you have to say, waiting longer, Jesus, give me time to get to play that. Because yesterday I talked about so-and-so. This morning I said some bad things to my wife, to my husband, or to my kids.
Come on, brothers.
Give me time to get right. He's not going to give you time to do nothing. Then you better get it right today. Amen. That way, we don't have to worry about it, Johnny Ray. I told Darrell, me and Darrell and Kathy was talking one morning, I said, it's time to be quiet. The Bible says, study to be quiet. Time to keep your mouth shut and not say nothing. Time to get better off that way. But we ain't that way. I've been studying on a message about a disease, Bobby, is sweeping the church world. And I'm going to preach that in the near future when I get it together. And when I do, to my opinion, everybody in the house will have to run to the altar and go to church. If we don't go over this, we're home to be with the Lord. It's only day church with every head bowed, nobody looking around. I want you to pray. Pray for the lost. If you're here today, you know what you need. Let me invite you to come and give your life to Jesus. Bad things are coming through Revelation time. But we don't have to go through that. If we're here when the rapture takes place, Jesus is going to take us home with him. If we're right. But if we're not right, he's going to leave us here to suffer the Antichrist. And that's not going to be a pleasant thing. That's why I try to tell my son that bad things are coming upon the land. And he said, Daddy, I know as much about it as you do. I said, probably, son, you do. But to know it and don't live it, it don't profit you nothing. Hell still awaits you. You better get it together. Church, let me invite you tonight to come. Give your life to Jesus. I'm not saying that I can send a funeral. Beg you all day, but I'm not coming back there. Trying to get you to come to the altar. I don't do that. My people better not bother nobody. Amen. It's lost without God. Don't go back and don't fool with them. They know what they need. They know where to get what they need. It's right here on the altar. So today, church, won't you come and give your life to God? Do you think about it a lot? But today's the day. You need to do something about it, amen. Because the time is running out for us. Amen. Amen. Enough of that. Remember, you can repent anywhere, anytime. If you see yourself in trouble, you think your next breath is going to be your last. My advice is to repent. Amen. Because I don't recommend that, but it'll work. It'll work for the thief on the cross. Why not for you? Amen. So tonight, church, I love you. I know sometimes the word gets tough, gets hard, but just the word. Good to have each and every one. Darrell, Christian, his family. Good to have them, Sherry, and her family.
Amen.
Good to have them. People got sick. They couldn't come today because of sickness. I can understand that. So pray for them, church. Pray for the lady at Mom's Hole. Face a hard thing tomorrow. And I ask that y'all pray for that lady at Mom's Hole. Amen. God knows what she needs. I've been asking God to help her with the needs that she needs met tomorrow.
So do they church.
Pray for my brother.
Pray for my son William. Lost without God, I like to see him saved. I like to see your children saved. Amen. I pray for your kids. I see them along the road. I see them in the stores, Bobby. Even when I see them, I pray for them. They don't know what I'm praying for them anyway.
All right.
God save it. Save it. I mean, a good Christian, Mr. Lord. Just save him. Have him to come and give his life to you.
Yes, amen.
Amen. Tony, that's all I know to do, honey.
When I face
churches, I say, God, give them people souls for the labor.
Yes, amen.
Amen. Mm-hmm. Nobody in that old truck but me, but I'm still praying for every church that I'll pass. I ask God to give the people souls for the labor. A lot of people go to them churches, they'll never come to this church.
Sure.
Afraid of them preachers are preaching up hell. They'll know they need to get saved. Amen. So in that church, they are joy in serving God. They're happiness in serving God. And nobody got no more joy than I have. Nobody no happier than I am. And then why? Because my name was written in the Lamb's Book of Life. And I know that. So why should I be sad, Bobby? You say it about nothing. I'm like, oh, lovely. I'm just getting drunk to death about anything. Amen. It don't matter. God help. Oh. So today, church, rejoice with what you got. Rejoice with who you are. Amen. Don't be sad about nothing. No time to be sad. Anybody?